And the only difference is there's two teams in Chicago in baseball, and there's only one hockey team in Toronto, which is a goddamn disgrace.
It is a disgrace, because I'm going to tell you this. If you take a look at the populace of the greater GTA and you know, the anything within an hour of Toronto, right? We have a population that would support technically three teams.
Yep, like New York.
Technically, it would support three teams. And this bureaucracy is mind-boggling to me, Phil.
I agree with you, Frank. I think it's ridiculous. There should be another team in the Toronto market. I just don't understand. But the Leafs are that powerful that they don't want one.
Because they bring that much money into the league, and they push that money into all these other teams who don't get that kind of money. Yeah. That's where the power is. That's where the clout is.
Phil, they're so powerful, they keep the other teams out.
It's criminal. It's a very old crony fucking rule, which is total fucking criminal.
And they're so powerful, Phil, that they keep the other investors. Who's the guy who had the BlackBerry thing? He was going to have a team in Kitchener-Waterloo.
He never had a chance.
I know, what about the arena they're going to build up in King City, Newmarket area? I mean,
no,
Hamilton.
It's not Newmarket or King City. It's in Markham.
Markham,
that's
okay, all right.
It's going up to Markham, and that's a goal. There's very, very, very powerful people
all
behind
right. I was
it.
Off by 5 minutes.
And there's one particular powerful person involved, and that's a builder, and you know who it is, Frank, and they're doing the smart thing. They're keeping their mouths quiet. They don't say anything.
They've decided to build this center there, and in the worst-case scenario, it becomes a civic center, and that's the end of that.
Okay, how many seats, Frank? How many seats?
It'll be 20,000.
Jesus, that's quite a civic center.
It'll be a civic center, and you know, it encompasses Unionville, Markham, Stouffville. You know, it's a big area now.
And if anything, if they've been told basically, and if they're smart, they've been told this, build it and don't say a word about what you want to do, and maybe you'll get the chance.
And don't piss off Gary Bettman.
Just like they did in Winnipeg. Yeah. Just keep your mouth shut.
Because Basile with BlackBerry pissed off Bettman.
He didn't piss off.
Yes, he pissed
him off. He sued the league.
Well, what do you think that's called?
Here's my fucking point. The average human being who's a Toronto Maple Leaf fan technically cannot afford to take his wife and his kid or kids to a game. It will be his paycheck.
So they go to Buffalo. They go to Buffalo and spend.
Yeah, but why the fuck should they do that?
Because it's a club. Because it's a club, and that's the way the club works. I'm talking the club being the NHL. That's the way it works.
Well, Phil, you were part of that club. I mean, goodness, what's your two cents?
It is a club. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah.
And it's not. I can tell you, it's a hell of a lot harder now to get into that club than it was when I started in 1991, to get into that club. Then you had, guys that John Ziegler was the commissioner, and you had a guy like Billy Wirtz who was completely involved, and so was Eddie Snyder. And then you had some other teams that just wanted the money, and they didn't give a shit.
Yeah.
Well, and they've got, they've always...
Okay, but I agree with everything you guys are saying, but this is 2016, okay? And the whole logic of the NHL is to become more and more and more popular. And I don't understand why they allow expansion in New York, New York Islanders, New Jersey Devils, Philadelphia Flyers, right? Pittsburgh Penguins, they're all within an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Well, and Phil made the point, Frank, when they brought in the Devils, that was a payout to Snyder because they were in the Philadelphia market. So there were people who wanted to make some money, and they were able to exert influence. It's always been that the Leafs are going to refuse to have another team in Toronto. That's bullshit. As soon as that building is built, there will be somebody who will pay a million, basically minimum, for the Toronto franchise that will go to the Markham area in the big, beautiful building on 407, and the Leafs will get their commensurate share.
Yeah.
Let me ask you guys something, because maybe I'm stupid.
They will get territorial rights.
If it's a boys' club, I'm being facetious here. If it's a boys' club, and there's no fucking chance that the Toronto Maple Leafs will allow another team. Why are we building that whole area of the 407? And if you go to the 407 and Woodbine and just go north there, there's 4 billion new restaurants and there's hotels that are opening up there now. Why would you do that? I would say somebody knows something, and they're all keeping their mouth shut.
I would say basically you're right, and Bill was right. When the price is right, and if it gets to $1 million, because $500 million was the entry fee for the Las Vegas franchise, when the price is right, if it's $1 million or higher, then the deal will be made.
$1 million or higher?
I'm talking $1 billion. I'm sorry, a billion. I meant a billion.
You sound like Austin Powers.
I said it's $1 billion,
One
Frank. Okay.
$1 billion.
Correct
him.
I realize. Don't get defensive. I know what you meant. I was joking.
Listen, they are going to expand another team at least. I absolutely am convinced that Quebec has been promised to get in there as soon as the Canadian dollar comes back a little bit or what have you. And then after that, for $500 million, and then after that, they're going to raise it again. And they probably raise it $750 million for a franchise.
And some franchise right now will move.
I agree with Gary Lefkoe that once it gets to $1 billion, because if you take a look right now, it is 750 million Canadian, 800 million Canadian, because Las Vegas paid 750 U.S. And that is almost $1 billion Canadian.
Which is 750 Canadian, Frank.
And I'll tell you,
500 U.S.
And you're going to tell me the Columbus Blue, one of these teams is going to move to Toronto.
As of today's exchange, it's almost $800 million. What I'm saying is, I agree with Perry that it will be $1 billion Canadian.
And some team right now that's going to be moved.
Years ago.
All right. Do you guys agree that
another radio station? But anyway, that's just me.
What's that, Billy? Oh, we lost you there for a second.
I said 5 years ago, I said that Markham would have a franchise. I got it from a very reliable source. And the cost would be $1 billion.
I've heard you say that before, and you've been very consistent. Your prediction, I think, holds a lot of water because somebody must know something in that area because land is, they're going for $2.5 million, $3 million an acre, $4 million an acre for commercial. It's going up to $6 million, $7 million an acre. They're building hotels. All you got to do is take the 407, get off the Woodbine, go north to Highway 7, and it will blow you away. It's another metropolitan Toronto. There's hotels. There's huge strip malls with tons and tons of restaurants, movie theaters. It's unbelievable. It is going to be an entertainment district.
And you know Frank Rudy Brady was one of the
I know Rudy very
one
well.
Of the biggest
never,
developers
never,
in Toronto.
He's a very, very dear friend of mine. I've known Rudy for many, many, many years. He's a very bright man. He's a great lawyer. He's done me a lot of favors. He's bailed me out. He's a good guy. I've never ever discussed this project with him, and nor has he discussed it with me. But I know Rudy's a very smart man. The group with Rudy, you know, he's got a lot of, great and very articulate builders and developers that are in his group. And they've done, in their portfolio, they've done some incredible things, like incredible things.